It was good. This your boy, Mr. Tula Lab, CriminalGroove.com, Vintage Beats Productions. I'm just bringing you this quick tutorial today. FL Studio 11 was just released. I've been using it since yesterday. You know, it's pretty dope. I just wanted to do a quick tutorial on something I see that a lot of people have been asking about, and that is the legacy blocks. So I'm going to open up FL Studio. And once you get FL Studio 11 open, you know, this is the default project. And obviously, you know, when you look into your playlist, as you can see, they completely remove the legacy block patterns. Now, before I get into it, I just want to say, like, this whole block thing been going on for, like, a few years now since they first started mentioning that they was going to take the blocks out, and everybody started panicking. But I think what they did here is probably the best thing. Like, and you know, this is a good move for everybody, because really I still don't understand what the whole big issue is with the blocks. I mean, a lot of the things that they are providing now in this current update are features that were already there. They just made it more visible to people. So in order to access the legacy block mode, I would say, before they had an option in the options menu, for enable legacy blocks, as you can see, is gone from there. Now the only way to get legacy style block pattern sequencing, you have to go to File, New from Template, go to Other, and as you can see, they have a template set up for you called Blocks. Now, this is pretty cool. When you load up the template, as you can see, the playlist is set up for you to basically operate the same way, or sequence the same way you would using the legacy blocks. Now, I know you're looking at it like, well, that ain't blocks. Well, actually, it pretty much is. It's exactly the same thing. And I'm going to explain something to you. Basically, if you have your playlist snap set to bar, you can arrange the patterns the same way you would if you had blocks. As you can see, each pattern is locked to each track. So if I click on pattern 1, I can't put it down here. This is only going to paste pattern number 5. You understand what I'm saying? And this is something that's been in FL Studio. This is just a template that they created for you. Like, the actual lock to content menu was available in FL Studio, I believe, 10 and possibly 9 as well. Like, they always had that there. You can always set this up. This is just something that they're just making for you, so they can prove to you that you can do the same thing with patterns that you could have done with the block situation. And this is best, because in actuality, you're better off, because it's a whole lot more that you can do with patterns that you couldn't do with the blocks. But, you know, and this is a good move. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, basically, like, you know, to make it as close to the block situation as it can be, like I said, set your snap to bar, and you can basically do your patterns, and you can arrange, and it'll snap to bar, and there you go. You have your whole block sequencing, so everybody can stop crying and don't jump off a bridge and kill yourself or nothing. It's all right. Everything's gonna be okay. FL Studio 11 is here now, and yeah, that's basically all I wanted to show y'all today. FL Studio block mode, FL Studio 11 block mode. Check it out. Holla at me. Beats on deck. Mr. 211, CriminalGroove.com, Vintage Beat Productions. Go check me out. I got that tutorial out there on MachineMasters.com if y'all ain't checked that out. We got a whole series coming out for that, for using FL Studio and the machine. Go check that out. I got some more tutorials on my page. Please like, comment, subscribe. Hit me up. Peace.